Daddy, that means you shot this.
Washington number 31 jersey. I had the distinct privilege and special pleasure of coaching Pearl for all 3 years of his high school career. As everyone knows, he was an outstanding, dynamic player. From a coach's perspective, Pearl was very coachable and a team player, sacrificing for the sake of his team. As big of a star that he was a greater person who demonstrated humility and never forgetting his roots in the community. With all the accolades that Pearl received, he would be first to say if it wasn't for his teammates, Pearl wouldn't have achieved his success, always deflecting credit to his teammates. When he was a college star and also an NBA player, he would always come to the high to encourage players during the summer. Pearl would give free clinics to kids in the community. Some of Pearl's many highlights: scored close to 2,000 career points as a junior. He starred in defeating the undefeated number one team in the United States, Camden High School at Camden. He received numerous awards, and in his senior year, Pearl was voted to every first All-American team in the United States. Pearl demonstrated in his senior year, he was the best player in the United States by winning the MVP awards in both the prestigious McDonald's All-American All-Star Game in Atlanta and the Dapper Dan Classic in Pittsburgh against the best players in the country. Dwayne Pearl Washington is truly deserving of having his 31 jersey retired and will go down as one of the greats in Boys and Girls High School basketball history. In closing, I would be remiss if I didn't thank all the members of the Pearls Foundation with CEO J.D. Bennett for their great efforts and splendid work with the foundation in keeping Pearls' legacy alive. I hope everyone enjoys today's ceremony honoring the retirement of Dwayne Pearl Washington's jersey, Go Kangaroos.
So at this time, before we turn it over to his sister, we would like to make a presentation to the family. Jersey number 31. Let's let everybody see it. And of course, we have a picture of him with all of his professional teams. So on behalf of the Boys and Girls Campus, we would like to say thank you for allowing us to do this with you today.
Hold it in the front.
As his older sister, when he passed away, I looked up and I said, this is someone, something I need to keep going. And that was his legacy. And I promised myself and my family supported me that we would keep his legacy alive. He was a good-hearted person. I have not met anyone who has said one bad word about him. I don't know how many people can say that, but I can actually say of the people I met, they all kind of respected that little smile he gave and the way he was always approachable. I love my brother and all of us did. We loved him and we miss him terribly. But we will keep his legacy alive as long as we
Captain!
So, let me just say that there are so many other people that have helped out to make this trip, this journey that I have to do, made it a lot easier for me, is my family and friends that always supported me. I want to first do Debbie, who's his fiance.
Hello, family. This is such a special honor to Dwayne Washington. Why, the love of my life. First and foremost, education is first, and this is what we would tell the young people. What I love most about Dwayne is his humanity for love.
have me on. And this special tribute is so honoring, and I'm just so grateful for it and to be here to be a witness. Thank everyone for making this possible, starting with Jamie and his sister.
I'd like for his son, Dwayne Washington, Jr.
I ain't about to kick a man and tell him to get a pearl dig, but y'all already know. But y'all know what we came here for. I don't see no other jerseys in the rafters over here, so Pearl just started off. I don't know what will be next. They said somebody over here nice, but somebody else better show me they nice tonight, because I ain't coming out here for nothing. Somebody lost about 50 for y'all in the court. That's not a statement. I ain't trying to see coming from this end. And boys over here, like, they can't be quick. Look, they get these strategy together. All right, yeah. That's what I like to see, some competition. Y'all ready?
Yeah, we ready.
Y'all ready or not? I can't hear you. Chucky and Pearl in the building. Look, once that jersey go up in the rafters, y'all better do something here, man. I need somebody to get dunked on. I need a... See, Steph Curry, somebody come across his half court line of his son. Pearl, I'm gonna show y'all what he do.
Yeah.
If not, somebody give me a jersey, I'll show you how to do it. Yeah. All right, yeah, put that jersey up. Pearl deserves it. High school, I need a high school championship to go through here. I need it to go through here, right? It's going through here?
Yes, sir.
All right, why not? She ain't sound, she don't sound too excited. I don't know what y'all doing in practice. Somebody, y'all need to come to the baseline. Somebody come to the baseline. We used to do 17s when we were this quiet. I don't know, man. Y'all make it happen here. I thank everybody for coming out, showing respect, even the ones in the back that can't keep it quiet. I know y'all are the loud ones in class. But your teachers here, they know who you are. I know who you are, too. It's all right. The cheerleaders paying attention. They was from a minute ago. Appreciate y'all coming out. We can't wait to get it done. Want to see a good game tonight. Some ass whooping in the air is my only first word. Let's get it popping here. Thank y'all for the wall. Let's just stand and represent. Let me show up your man. Let the cowboy work. Let me know you. Let your man stand, baby. Let's go ahead and back. Pearl, Brooklyn, all day. We love y'all. Thank you. Dwayne Pearl Washington is one of the greatest players in history of New York City high school basketball. Dwayne Pearl Washington is one of the greatest players in the history of the Big East Conference.
Right.
In 2005, he was inducted into the New York City Basketball Hall of Fame. There was a Mount Rushmore of boys' high basketball based on what you did when you were in high school, not what you did afterwards. Because Lenny Wilkins only played 7 games here at boys' high. He's a mid-year graduate. It would be 2 unanimous locks for Mount Rushmore. Honey Hawkins, the Hawk, and Dwayne Washington, the Pearl. Third guy probably would be Hugo Green. The fourth base probably would be Mel Davis, but you can make an early argument Eldridge Webb. Anyone who saw him play knew what a great player he was, but not enough people knew what a good person he was. With a warm heart and the gentle spirit he had. When he passed away in 2016, I got a phone call from a friend. And frankly, they kept on repeating, "We lost Pearl, we lost Pearl." As shocked and sick as I was, I had to correct him. When you lose something, you don't know where it is. If you knew him, you knew exactly where Pearl was. With his loving father in heaven.